Good afternoon, sisters. Adriana Dela Cruz here, California State President for the Coalition of Labor Union Women. Thank you for being here for the CLUW talk series that we have. I have Alma Hernandez from the California Labor Board. Hello, Alma. Thanks for being here.
Hi, Alma.
Hi, Annalisa. Hi, Adriana, Nicole.
And then I have Annalisa Swan. Thank you. She's a Biden-Harris campaign guru. She is here for the big day. Hello, Annalisa. Thanks again for being here.
Thank you for having me on the show, Adriana.
And we have my number one, Nicole Pugh, driving across country there. Hello, Nicole. Thanks for being here. Vice President of California.
Thank you for having me. It's great to be here.
So what are we going to talk about today, ladies? Well, we have a lot of measures on the California ballot, and it's kind of sometimes hard to figure out what to vote for, or how to vote for, or to understand them. This one's a little bit more complicated because it was a yes on affirmative action in the 60s and then a no on affirmative action in the 90s. And now we're back to a yes. As we've seen this summer, it should be a yes, right? Let's talk about why it should be yes on 16. And let's talk a little bit about how 16 came about. And I think that in fairness, we have to go back to its origins. So let's talk about affirmative action. So this term was first used in the United States by JFK, John F. Kennedy, on the 6th of March, 1961. All right. Take affirmative action to ensure that applicants are employed and employees are treated fairly during employment without regard to their race, creed, color, or national origin. Okay, that was executive order number 10925. And then it affected women's as well, because during the from 1973 to 2003, it showed that the effect of affirmative action on advancing Black, Hispanic, and white women into management, professional, and technical occupation did occur during the 1970s and early 90s. However, there was a percentage of individuals who felt that we were given an unfair advantage by giving these underrepresented individuals a step up. Some people would say that they were put in front of the line over other races. And so there was a repeal, and that repeal occurred. And now we've seen again that there's a need for affirmative action. And post-apartheid era and affirmative action and the things that came out of that, and in China and Israel, and the unrest, and of course, the things that are happening across Europe and in other countries. So here we are in the United States. There's several, a multitude of states already have this in place. California repealed it, and now here we are, a ballot measure 16. Yes on 16 would reinstate the affirmative action policy. So I'm going to open it up for discussion. Alma, Annalisa, Nicole, what are your thoughts on this particular subject? And does it look like it's something that we can champion the Coalition of Labor Union to get behind? Yes, on 16.
Why don't you kick us off, Annalisa?
I'm sorry?
Why don't you kick us off?
Sure. I would say absolutely. We need to strongly vote yes on 16. Women in California only make 80 cents to every dollar earned by a male, and it's even worse, more disparity for women of color. So, you know, it's really offensive to me that we pride ourselves on being such a progressive state, yet we're only one of 9 states that has eliminated an affirmative action program. I mean, I definitely think we need to make steps to make reparations for all the harm that has been historically done to women and people of color. I was proud to march in the Black Lives Matter marches. And I really think we need to start removing these barriers that have been put in place in our system that have hurt women and especially people of color. And these things don't happen magically. They happen when we change the legal system to affirmatively get rid of these historical injustices. So yes, on 16.
Totally agree with Annalisa. I think just a quick historical for California is this is actually undoing the work of not only former Governor Pete Wilson, but also Ward Connerly, who during this during this time, they put on the ballot Proposition 209, and really were banking on a resentment in California against not only immigrants, but people of color. And I think what we have seen in the last few months with the protests around the murder of George Floyd is that Californians have turned a page, and we can agree that we made a mistake, and that we still in California still need measures in place that take into account an individual's race, gender, and socioeconomic status, because our structures are not just. They don't treat everyone equal. And so we need to put back in place these lenses that allow us to govern through a more just perspective. So yes, absolutely. I think if we could all stand behind a yes on 16, it benefits small businesses. A lot of the small business owners in California are women owned or people of color owned. And right now they can't compete with a lot of the big corporations that have the fancy grant makers and have the ability to apply for all of the grants and credits. And this will actually help more small businesses that are women and people of color owned have access to a lot of the services that are available to them that they just simply can't get their foot in the door right now.
Yeah, that's really all good points. I'm behind the measure. I'm all for fighting discrimination. And I feel like this is a positive for everyone, because it's equal opportunities for all.
Right. And I think we need to do as much as we can to help people. I mean, especially the pandemic. I mean, the pandemic is disproportionately affecting people of color. And having an affirmative action would be able to take some steps to use the power of our government to remedy some of these disparities that we're even seeing in healthcare and access to our services of our government. So like, it's needed now more than ever. This is like an urgent yes on 16.
Yeah, because I think, you know, without this affirmative action, small businesses in California and by women, I'm a business owner myself and a woman, and a person of color, you know, we would just, how can we fight against bigger and wealthier companies?
That's right.
A lot of these things. And so, you know, you have to support these micro units of change, because without them, you see what occurs. Right. And everyone should feel like they're given the opportunity based on their skill set. Not because, like we were just talking about another webisode of ours about Prop 122, and how you as a small individual Uber Lyft driver has that challenge. And that's another thing that could be better improved upon. I think that this Prop 16 would right some wrongs that we did over the last 20 years.
I think also it fights back against a misperception that rights are like pie. Like, just because you give more rights to somebody else does not take rights from you. Like, we should be working to lift everybody up, and we should all be organizing. We should all be moving forward and making a better society and more just social justice for everybody, not just laws for just a few people at the top that are white, wealthy, and have historically profited off of the labor of people of color. We need to fix these injustices, and we need to fix them now, not carry them over to future generations to solve. We need to solve it now.
Right. Yeah. So yes on 16, you heard it here, sisters. Yes on 16. Have you been getting a lot of positive feedback, Alma, while you're running the circuit on the Yes on 15 campaign in California?
Yes on 16 for affirmative action. This one, you know, this one, as you started off with saying, it gets confusing to folks, and this is one that confuses a lot of folks. It's a very simple ballot title to reverse the affirmative action repeal put on by the legislature, and so voters are not really understanding that what it actually does. And so it's so important for all of the ladies watching this webinar that we get the word out, because although there's no funded opposition, there's also, you know, the yes side also doesn't have a whole lot of money to communicate to all 21 million voters in California. Early voting has started. It started yesterday. And so for the folks that can vote and can get out and do the yes on 16 early, it'd be fantastic. This is kind of one of those measures that is so critically important and is so easy to fall under the radar just because it can be confusing. And so, you know, we encourage folks to read up on it. It is reversing, I think, a mistake that I think California voters made. It's important for the equality that we're all trying to seek here in California.
Mm-hmm. So let's, for those that want more information, you can go to the website, vote, V-O-T-E, yes, Y-E-S, on prop16.org. Vote yes on prop16.org. Very important, ladies. Very important.
Very important.
You know what? Let's segue into talking about Prop 15.
Okay.
Let's talk about Prop 15 because that's another important measure. I know that there's a lot out there. And for those that want to know more information and how a union and labor endorse these measures, go to the California Labor Federation website, and then you can see the full list there.
Absolutely.
And we said no on 22. We said yes on 16. Let's say yes on 15.
We're saying yes on 15. Absolutely.
Mama, tell me about 15.
So, you know, we've been talking a lot about equality and the economy and the impacts that workers in low wage jobs has on the rest of us that have a union job with benefits. And Proposition 15 actually closes one of the biggest loopholes that big corporations use in our economic structures in California by requiring commercial properties that are over $3 million to pay the fair market value in property taxes. And so I'll just quickly go back. In 1978, voters passed Proposition 13 with the intention of making sure that homeowners were never paying more than 1% on their property taxes. That has still, that will still remain in effect under Prop 15. But what ended up happening, and voters didn't intend to do, was that corporations use the same loophole that protects the homeowners to also not pay any more than what they, than the 1% on the current market value of then. So what they'll do is they don't ever transfer the ownership of the property. So you have Disney, you know, parks like Disneyland that have their ticket prices have, you know, gone up to
$1 a pop.
Correct, right? And they're all still only paying the property taxes of 1978. You have Michael Dell in Santa Monica, who very creatively bought a hotel and split the ownership between him and his wife to not trigger reassessment, so that they could continue to pay property taxes of the land value of 1978. Sadly, the courts found that that was legal. And so what Proposition 15 intends to do is to close that loophole. It will remain the 1% protection for homeowners. It does not touch homeowners. It creates an exemption for any small businesses under $3 million. It protects agricultural land. So any, you know, a lot of the California economy is dependent very much on agriculture. We feed the world. It does not, it exempts agricultural land. And more importantly, it actually will help save homeowners money, because what has happened is there's been a huge shift. It used to be that corporations would pay, it was a 50-50. Corporations paid property taxes about 50%, and so did the homeowners. That has now shifted. Homeowners account for a much larger percentage of the property tax paid in California. So when corporations pay their fair share, we will also benefit because our share will decrease as well. And lastly, what it does, it will fund local government services and our schools. It raises approximately $12 billion that goes directly to Prop 98 and our schools, local school districts. It does not go to the state, and it goes directly into the local cities and governments to provide all of the services that we need to keep our parks open, to be able to fund our social care, our social services sector, to keep our firehouses open, and more importantly, our public hospitals that have borne the brunt of this pandemic, to allow them to also have access to additional resources. So it's at a time when we are looking at the impact of what the economy is looking and the great imbalance of it. Prop 15 is the only measure with that raises enough money that makes structural reforms, which is what Californians are looking for in this moment.
Yeah, so we're just making it fair because we're consumers. We pay the exorbitant prices that they ask for.
That's right. That's right.
I love Disneyland. I always enjoy my time there, but I do pay for it.
You right. Know? And I look at it as an equity issue. You know, these businesses are doing business in our state. They're using our roads. They profit off of our labor. They're, you know, insinuating themselves into our daily life. It's like they should be funding the roads that they're using. They should be contributing back to our communities. And this will help undo some of the damage that we've had since 1978 with Prop 13, which basically froze their taxes at about 1.1% of their property valuation. And now here we are in 2020. I mean, we need to start valuing things at their actual value now, not what it was back in 1978. And we need these businesses to contribute and pay their share. They shouldn't be allowed to just dodge their taxes. You know, in our state, if they want to do business and be here, they should be contributing just like us as individuals do.
Yeah, because otherwise we make up for it in other ways. We're taxed in other ways, and we still end up paying for it anyway.
Correct.
It's just the corporations again here who are saying, "Hey, it's only fair that I give back to the community. Let me help you pay that." I don't hear that.
Right.
I just hear the government saying, "Adriana, I need to charge you more money, or I need to tax you more because we need to pay for that."
Right.
I need to pay for those community services. My bills are going up and up because I'm myself as a stakeholder here has to contribute because it has to be paid for. I have to pay for the firefighters that are there, and they're deserving of it. But yes, I mean, corporations again have to. I want them to show me what they say in these propaganda campaigns that they pay millions of dollars for.
Right.
Treat me like I'm valuable, right. Because I may not be an Uber Lyft driver. I'm going to say that again. No, on 22. But I'm an individual, and I could, you know, an Uber Lyft driver could be a relative of mine. It could be a brother of mine. It could be, you know, I mean, they're it touches us. It affects us. If I use the service, it's going to affect me as a client, as a person in that car. I put my life into the hands of that individual. I want them to be as protected as possible because that's going to protect me too.
That's right.
Well, so yeah. Now we're saying yes, yes on 15.
Yes on 15.
Now where's that tax money going to go to benefit? Well, you heard it. It's going to go to infrastructure. It's going to go to community services. It's going to help, you know, the unsheltered in our communities.
Right.
We pay for it anyway. We're paying for it now.
Yeah, that's a good point, Adriana. The money is going to go to local governments. I mean, it was local governments that have been starved by that rule from 1978. Right. So we need to start investing in our infrastructure, in our schools, in our communities. And these businesses, they want the privilege of doing business here with none of the responsibility to the community. That's what is really galling to me about back from 1978.
Yeah. Right.
These corporations show me the money, show me their loyalty. I, as a consumer, will appreciate that. I'm going to say, thank you, Starbucks.
That's right.
Thank you, Robux Juice. I'm going to spend my hard earned cash in your business because you're loyal to me.
Right.
If Jeff Bezos says, Adriana, you know what? You're right. I don't need trillions of dollars. Can't take it with you. Right. But I'm gonna reinvest and make this world a better place to be in. You know, I'm going to invest in you, and not only you, but all the other persons like you, because you deserve it. Right. Show me that I deserve it. And then you deserve my loyalty as a customer. Is that a bad thing to say? Is that a bad thing to want? You know, make me feel that you care about me.
Right.
Because then, because then I'll support you. We're, you know, union people, you know, we know who to support because that they support us. Show me the love and I will show you my respect and, yeah. And I will work for you. You know, I will be happy. I'd be more than happy to with a team. It's teamwork makes the dream work. Right, ladies?
That's right.
Here we go. Yes. Yes. On 16. Yes. On 15. No.
On no 22. On 22.
Right. I always think team together, everyone achieves more.
There you go. Absolutely. Yes.
Yeah. Cause we're all, you know, we're all here to live, you know, coexist. It's not saying you, me, it's us. We're in it to win it together. Well, any other last final thoughts here before we, you know, I want to say vote. If you haven't registered.
Vote. Annalisa, like your life and your rights depend on it because they do.
Show up, be presente, si se puede.
I'm going to also say LGBTQ rights are on the ballot, women's rights, people of color's rights, our environment, our government, our Supreme Court, our president, our vice president, our local level support up and down, blue, up and down.
That's right.
Yeah. And don't forget, number one, union and women.
Right. That's right.
Union rights, everything is on the ballot.
We can do this. We got this. We can do this, yeah. Right? Yeah. You know, I just like if Beyonce says women can rule the world, why not?
Right.
Wait for a long time. It's been a lot of, let's try something different.
I am so excited. We could have our first Black, first South Asian American vice president, our Senator Kamala Harris. Vote.
Oh, yeah. That's going to be another series. That's going to be a fun, fun day.
Yeah.
And manifest the win, ladies. Manifest the win. Yes, we can.
Get into existence.
Yes, right. We can. We can do this. We got this. We got this. And men who empower women, who realize our worth, you know, we care about you. We love you. We respect you. We're like this. We're together.
Yes.
We're together in this work. We're not separate. We're a family. We got this. Well, thank you, Alma, for your time today.
Really. Thank you for having. What a pleasure to be with you, Annalisa, and Nicole, and Adriana.
This was so much fun. Thank you, Adriana, for inviting me. It was so fun to be on this panel with you, Alma, Nicole, and Adriana.
Thank you, Nikki, for your time today. Look forward to seeing you soon. All right.
Thank you all for coming. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, sisterhood. We can do this.
We can do this. Sisterhood. Yes.
No on 22. Yes on 15. Yes on 16.
Great. Thank you. Have a good Sunday.
Thank you. Good night, everyone.
Vote. Vote. Vote.